healthcare, in my opinion, is one of those things. If you get to a point of no return, there is no return.
How much information we now have, how many pieces of data we in the healthcare system are constantly gathering, it's really just reached the point that it's beyond human capacity.
I'm Sarah, and 3 years ago, I was diagnosed with endometriosis after about 20 years of trying to get diagnosed. I don't think I ever knew that I had any other options. I thought it was just the cards that I'd been dealt, for lack of a better word. So you're trying to be honest about the pain that you're feeling and the symptoms that you have, and you're being told, oh, this is a normal part of womanhood. And I think that shaped my journey and made it longer, because in a way that just made me stop looking for an answer. I had been to like so many doctors in between, and I can imagine that a lot of other women experience the same.
Diagnosis splits our lives into before and after. The failure to diagnose is a spiral of uncertainty and fear. It is an odyssey fought by millions of patients and healthcare providers across thousands of diseases and conditions. In women's health alone, for every one woman diagnosed with a health condition, four go undiagnosed.
So when you hear these stories, and I was hearing them on a daily basis, it occurred to me to ask the question why this was the case. If all of this data is being captured already, then why is it that still up to 90% of the patients are being left untreated or undertreated? So for me, it was important to do something about it.
Early on in my career, patients would come to see me and their mothers would bring into the office thick binders full of their child's medical records from everything that's ever been done for their child, because their parents were so invested in trying to find an answer that no one had been able to find. The technology got better, but the basic idea was the same. So I would have patients come to me like that who'd been on these long journeys where they're seeing lots of different specialists and really still not finding that underlying answer that ties everything together. I always found that if you didn't know where you were, how do you know where you're going?
So when we were building Pangaea, it was very important for us to mimic what a physician would do manually. And what does that mean? A physician does not take decisions randomly. They take decisions based on the information that they have access to by virtue of what the patient is telling them and by virtue of what's in the patient record. Therefore, to mimic all of that through technology, you have to imbibe all that medical knowledge and all those aspects of a physician-patient interaction into technology. And you've got to deliver it so that the physician understands that that's what's happening, because that's when they're going to trust it.
Doing great, how are you?
So I was actually looking at COPD and I was amazed how there's a huge burden of patients who aren't on guideline-directed therapy. Apparently over half of patients with COPD remain undiagnosed or undertreated.
So when I see a patient, when they come in, there are three channels in my brain switched on. So my ears are like actively listening to the patient, what they are saying. And my eyes are looking at the electronic health records, like scroll down quickly, go through all the information. And at the same time, my brain has to think about all the disease-related information, guidelines, treatment. It's like a decision-making triage, all these three channels working together in these 10 minutes.
So I think it's really interesting that now patients are like, well, I can give you a load more symptoms. Like, I can track on my watch that my heart rate was this at the time or whatever else. And I think having some form of technology to help us sift through that ever-increasing amounts of data, generate those insights, I think is going to be critical. Like, why is that exciting to you? What do you think you'll be able to do next with Pangaea Data?
I think the most exciting part is now we have access to all of this very powerful foundation model or generative model.
So I'm the head of AI at Pangaea Data. So I'm leading our technical efforts, especially focusing on development of our AI platform PALLUX and also delivery to our customer. So at Pangaea, we spend most of our time incorporating the clinical expertise and knowledge defined by the clinical guidelines into our AI systems. We match the data we capture and retrieve from the patient data with the clinical criteria defined by the clinical guidelines. So when we combine them together, we interpret the patient data, and that is a moment where AI inference is important. We can provide that response in real time back to the clinicians, and the clinicians can decide what is the best action point for the patients themselves to make sure the patient will be on the best care pathways according to the clinical guidelines. PALLUX is able to deal with all these different scenarios and compatible with the different systems that healthcare systems are using themselves. So we connect with those different interfaces, and of course, thanks to the support from NVIDIA and Microsoft, we can connect to those pipelines more easily.
So 50% of COPD patients are undiagnosed, and you guys are able to find five times more by using your platform to look through the data. That's great. So then patients get treatment faster, and we know they're on the right pathways.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's the whole point of everything we do. So if we can pick up more patients with COPD, get them on guideline concordant therapy, that's one less admission spent in hospital. That's time they can spend at home with their families and friends, and just living the best life they can. So it makes a huge change in people's lives.
An AI-powered clinician will only be a better clinician. It will be a clinician that has more brain capacity to actually talk to you, to understand you, to be more empathetic, to actually think and be supported in the decision-making and personalize their treatments towards you. We have so much data. They're just locked up in our health records. This can be changed. We can totally unlock that massive wealth of information and discover completely new things to revolutionize the landscape.
Here in the UK, Pangaea Data and the NHS recently deployed the PALLUX platform to discover undiagnosed and miscoded cancer cachexia patients, a wasting disease that is directly responsible for at least 20% of cancer deaths. PALLUX found six times the patients compared to traditional approaches. That kind of early diagnosis can cut cachexia treatment costs by as much as 50% and potentially save as much as £1 billion per year.
What's extraordinary about Pangaea Data is that Pangaea Data has identified an area that we oftentimes don't think quite a bit about, which is the massive variation in care that is available today. As we think about how healthcare needs to evolve, this will be a critical component. We know that technology can help. We know that Pangaea Data solutions work, but we also have to find ways to make this workflow compatible. And that means we have to think about how all these different systems can work together.
You've got to be explainable, which develops high trust, but also you've got to make sure that that information is delivered to the physician in a compliant manner. And this is where Azure does a phenomenal job. The fact that they have already done the groundwork to be compliant across all different countries and territories, it immediately instills that confidence that you are a known entity, a trusted entity. Beyond just the technology, you're a team that can be trusted and will definitely execute. And that goes a long way.
It's very exciting to watch Pangaea Data taking the sovereign AI approach of bringing personalized care and democratized care across the globe. NVIDIA has been in healthcare life science space for the last decade, and we prioritize our time in digital bio, digital health, and digital devices. We also help Pangaea Data with technical acceleration, for example, using NVFlare, which is a federated learning approach that helps train centralized model, preserve patient privacy without moving the data.
So the collaboration with Microsoft and NVIDIA, the most exciting part is the access to the AI technologies, especially the most powerful large language models in the world right now, With the large language models available through Microsoft Azure, powered by NVIDIA GPUs, we can perform more complex reasonings as close to as what a clinician would do themselves in a clinic.
Microsoft and NVIDIA are working together to help Pangaea Data accomplish their goals. We're leveraging the Microsoft Azure environment, the NVIDIA GPUs. Ultimately, this is the combination that will allow us to be able to not only accomplish the goals today, but think about what's possible in the future. The challenges that Pangaea Data are solving are global challenges, identifying individuals that need treatment, finding gaps in care, and ultimately the approach that they have is something that can be applied in any setting across the globe.
I was at a dinner not so long ago with some friends, and as it happens at most of these dinners, you know, you get asked what you are doing and what you are building. And I simply said, we're helping find untreated and undertreated patients. One of them just simply said, we bless you. We want you to do really well. They weren't coming at it from a financial standpoint. They were simply coming at it from their own personal experience, where they had been either untreated or undertreated for the longest time for a very severe condition. So you can imagine, if there was something like PALLUX sitting on the Microsoft and NVIDIA infrastructure in the background, quietly just doing its thing and just simply surfacing that intelligence at the point of care, that impact is going to resonate for that entire life of that patient and their family, and perhaps for generations to come.
So when I got my diagnosis the first time, they rolled me out and I was still pretty high from being under anesthesia. And the doctor walked in and she was like, yep, we did find endometriosis. And I cried for a little while. My husband's like, what's wrong with you? And I'm like, I knew it. Like, I knew it was there. And like the validation that I felt from that was, it was pretty incredible. Like, yes, it sucked. Like, I got diagnosed with like a thing that's not gonna go away. But just after fighting for so long and just the relief of knowing I was right and like that I did know my body was such a great thing for me.
It was always very amazing to me that families didn't necessarily always hang their hopes on getting a cure. I think what really meant the most to a family was that someone was trying their best. Someone was really standing next to them in that dark cave, holding their hand, and was with them for that journey. And I think medicine has lost some of that because of all these mundane tasks that are demanded of clinicians these days. So I think if we can leverage the power of AI to do those mundane tasks for us, whether it's the clinicians, whether it's the patients, their families, their loved ones, the outcomes will be better. And that human connection is a large part of that.
When our product PALLUX is deployed behind the firewalls of these organizations in healthcare and in pharmaceuticals, and they're able to find more patients who are falling in these care gaps and bring them back onto the relevant care pathway, that's exactly what these organizations are there to do.
Healthcare is often a story about people losing time and struggling to find answers that are hidden in plain sight. But now, AI-powered tools like the PALLUX platform can help offer patients and their families clear direction, real answers. There is no denying that for many, life after a diagnosis is defined by hard decisions, more budgeting, disappointment, and triumph. But what's most important is that the road ahead is finally illuminated.